assembly meeting in a very long time, I'm realizing that, you know, I haven't started yet, I don't know what we're going to talk about or what you'll ask me. I think we should do it more often. I did want to get a plug for the census. Can I do that?
Of course.
Can I do that?
Yes. He has
a plug. Yeah, but here we go. All right. Well, the latest numbers are percentages of compliance, so to speak, for the city of Ithaca and Conference County, probably a little lower than they should be. And we can actually look at that to specific districts in the city, and we already knew that it was going to be very tough to have thousands of students remember among all the other dozens of things you have to remember to do every week to get the census forms back. Of course, those who live in group quarters or dorms have a different situation than people who live off campus.
If one person is found in violation of the noise ordinance in a residential building, all members of the residential building, present or not, can be fined. How is something like that allowed?
That has come about over the years. And what I've been told is what happens when there was a complaint in the past and a police officer shows up and asks who lives here, everyone says nobody. We don't know. And so that had caused the most strict writing of the noise ordinance, according to what I've heard from the police department in the past. And so I think that's why it became more broadly construed with